It's strange to think that more people have walked on the moon than have been to the deepest parts of our ocean. But with the development of recent astronomical instruments and new scientific developments, humans have been able to delve deep into the universe and study its many wonders. Stay tuned to find out exactly how massive the universe actually is. Number 10. You're old. Well, the universe is anyway. In fact, the universe is 13.7 billion years old, give or take 130 million years. Well, to put this into perspective, our solar system is only about 4.6 billion years old. Life on Earth began about 3.8 billion years ago. And humans like us, Homo sapiens, have only been around for about 200,000 years. Literally a blink of the eye in the history of the universe. To date the universe, scientists have examined the date between when the Big Bang occurred and today, and what they have discovered has astounded us. Before the Big Bang is the realm of speculation, though, and cosmologists debate what, if anything, existed before that. On the other hand, scientists have been able to trace the history of the universe back to within the first seconds and minutes after the Big Bang. This is impressive since we've only been here for 200,000 years. Number 9. It's huge. The universe is very big. The distance from the Earth to the edge of the observable universe is 46 billion light years. This leads astronomers and scientists to calculate that the observable universe is about 91 billion light years in diameter. Distances so large they are incomprehensible. But what does the universe consist of? Well, it contains billions of galaxies, which in turn contain solar systems, stars, planets, nebula, black holes, and much more. There could be as many as 10 billion galaxies. That puts our own existence into perspective. We live on a small planet that orbits a dwarf star with the 7 other planets that make up our solar system. But when we look beyond the boundaries of the solar system, we quickly realize that the Earth and even the Sun are very small in comparison to some of the supergiants astronomers have identified. Although it's impossible to imagine these sizes, the Sun is about 109 times the diameter of the Earth. Well, the largest stars in the universe can be thousands of times larger than our Sun, which is just beyond imagining. Although the universe is full of these planets, stars, and galaxies, they only make up about 5% of the total mass of the universe. So, what makes up the other 95%? Number 8. Our galaxy, the Milky Way. Not just a candy bar, the Milky Way is the galaxy our planet and solar system are situated in. Its diameter is between 100,000 and 180,000 light years. And it contains an estimated 100 to 400 billion stars, and at least 100 billion planets. It's so big that even if humans created a spaceship that could travel at the speed of light, it would still take at least 1,000 years to cross it. Every star you can see with the naked eye is part of the Milky Way. It can best be seen as a band of white light arching across the night sky. Today, because of light pollution, you need to be in a really dark part of the world to be able to see it clearly. But back before the advent of electricity and large cities, our ancestors would have seen a much more detailed picture of the sky. Many people throughout history have theorized about what exactly the Milky Way is, such as the Greek philosopher Aristotle, the Persian astronomer Abu Rayhan al-Biruni, and the Andalusian astronomer Avampes, just to name a few. Not only that, but there are countless of myths and legends about the origins of the Milky Way and what it is. But thankfully, recent scientific developments have given us tools to understand our existence outside of stories. Number 7. Feeling hot, hot, hot. What planet in our solar system do you think is the hottest? Simple logic would have you believe that the planet closest to the Sun, Mercury, would be the hottest, right? Well, it's not. Instead, at the position of second planet from the Sun, Venus holds the title for the hottest planet in our solar system, with a maintained temperature of 462 degrees Celsius, which is hot enough to melt lead. But why is Venus hotter than Mercury? Well, Venus has a thick atmosphere that traps the runaway greenhouse effect, whereas Mercury barely has an atmosphere. As a result, there is nothing to trap the sun's warmth on Mercury. This causes the temperature to drop as low as minus 173 degrees Celsius at night. It just goes to show that the most obvious conclusion isn't always the right one, and this is definitely the case with space. Number 6. Do you see what I see? We already mentioned that we live in the Milky Way galaxy, so it should come as no shock that every star you can see in the night sky is situated in the Milky Way. This means that we can't see anything outside of our galaxy without utilizing modern astronomical instruments. But what do we see when we look at the night sky? Well, because light has to travel from so far away, what we see is an image of what our galaxy used to look like. For example, if it takes light from a distant star 200 light years to reach Earth, we would be viewing what that star looked like 200 years ago. Another example is our closest star, the Sun. It's located only 92.9 million miles away, which means that if the Sun stopped burning, we wouldn't know about it for 8 minutes and 20 seconds. To think of it another way, we are never viewing the universe in its current state, only what it used to look like. Astronomers are, in effect, the historians of the universe. Number 5. Voyager 1 and 2. It's not only our neighboring planets that astronomers and scientists have attempted to study by sending robots into space. Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 are robotic probes used by an American scientific program to study the outer solar system and beyond. Located 13,034,348,240 miles away from the Earth, and counting, Voyager 1 is the furthest human-made object in space. In August 2012, it became the first human-made object to enter interstellar space. Unfortunately, though, the mission is expected to end in 2025 when the probe's generators will no longer have enough electric power to continue operating the equipment. But the Voyager robotic probes aren't just pieces of scientific equipment. Each one carries a gold-plated audiovisual disc that contains greetings in 55 languages, music, pictures of Earth, and scientific information. In the event that they are ever found by intelligent life forms, they are a message from us to them. Perhaps one day, in thousands, millions, or even billions of years from now, intelligent life forms may one day find the echo of humanity floating around in space. And they'll probably wonder while we're shooting record players at them. Number 4. Black Hole Sun. Black holes are like the nightmares of the universe, and they have puzzled astronomers and scientists since their discovery. There are three types of black holes known to scientists. Stellar black holes, which are formed by the collapse of individual stars. Supermassive black holes, whose formation is not exactly known. And intermediate black holes, which could be the result of stars in a cluster colliding in a chain reaction. But what exactly is a black hole? Well, they are regions of space that have very strong gravitational effects. So strong that not even light can escape them. Due to their nature, astronomers are unable to directly view them with modern scientific instruments, and instead must rely on observing their effect on nearby matter. These mysterious features are found throughout the universe, and recently, scientists have discovered one near the heart of the Milky Way. But thankfully, the nearest one to Earth is about 1,600 light years away. Number 3. Nebula. A nebula is the name given to an interstellar cloud of dust, helium, hydrogen, and other gases. Some nebulae are believed to measure millions of light years in diameter, but even though they are so large, they are far less dense than any vacuum created on Earth. So how are they formed? Well, some are the result of gases already in the interstellar medium, while others are believed to be created from materials shed by stars in late stages of their stellar evolution. So, what is their function? Well, stars and planetary systems are formed from the gas and dust within some of the nebulae, making them stellar nurseries. Number 2. Expanding Universe. The universe is expanding and its rate of expansion is increasing. But what does this mean? Well, the idea that the universe is expanding is a modern idea. from the early 20th century. But knowledge that the rate of expansion is accelerating is more recent. In the 1990s, it came as a shock to scientists to find that their measurements suggested the expansion was not slowing down as previously thought, but was in fact speeding up. So what's making it speed up? Unsurprisingly, we don't know. But recent suggestions think it may be linked to something called dark energy. And we'll get to that in a bit. If the expansion of the universe is accelerating, does that mean that the universe is infinite? Again, scientists don't know. But the general consensus is that the expanding universe theory suggests it could continue to expand forever. At least humans will have enough time to develop the technology needed to travel the universe. Number 1. Invisible stuff. Everything we can see and measure in the universe only makes up 5% of the universe. So, what makes up the rest? This has been a question that puzzles scientists and astronomers alike. It is now believed that roughly 70% of the universe is made of dark energy, a force that repels gravity, while dark matter, an invisible substance, makes up roughly the other 25%. Dark matter is impossible to detect with current instruments, but scientists are confident it exists due to the gravitational effects it appears to have on galaxies. Dark energy is even stranger, and scientists have no explanation for what it is. There are theories, but like dark matter, our current instruments are unable to measure it. Recent research has led some to believe that the repelling characteristics of dark energy might be linked to the acceleration of the expansion of the universe. Nearly everything in the universe is beyond comprehension for most of us, but dark matter and dark energy take it to a whole different level. Thankfully, scientists will continue investigating this mystery, and hopefully one day we will have a better understanding of what makes up most of the universe. Tell us what you think about the mysterious and invisible dark matter and dark energy in the comments below. Take a moment to subscribe so you get notified when it's time to learn more amazing stuff. See ya!